Hi, look, I've been given this Elna lock L4 machine to set up and explain how it works. So I've not used it before, but I pretty much will take you through the process of how to use it. Firstly, setting it up, you've got to get your cords, plug them in, and put the pedal on the floor. Make sure they're not all tangled. Make sure that you're not going to trip over them when you stand up. Get a chair that's at the right height. Maybe this one could be a little bit higher if it was extendable and I could take myself up a little bit higher maybe. I want to have my nose in line with the needles, like a normal sewing machine, a domestic machine or an industrial machine. Have your nose in line with the needles because that's where you're sewing. Be able to see down here. The key with an overlocker is that this is neatening the edge of your thread. Of your stitching. So it's got a little blade in here and that's the key here. So I'll just explain how this opens up. You open up the covers, you can see inside. Most machines will have a little threading diagram there. Look at it really closely. They've set up here that they've got red on the stitching here to explain it. That's the outer thread, the inner thread being blue, yellow, the top looper, and the green one being the upper loop, the under looper. The loopers are the threads that you can sit on the, like see on the top, and they go like the zigzag almost. And underneath is a green one that's almost the zigzag. So that's covering the edge, and they link at the sides to cover the edge of the threads, the fabric, so that it doesn't fray in the wash. Alrighty, so that's one cover, and the other cover opens up on this side here, which you might like to have a quick look on. So if you want to have a quick look on that side. So, when you're closing these up, often they're just pushing them to open it up. So you just push it. And when you're closing this, make sure it's linked in properly. It's not sort of flapping out here somewhere. So if you want to come back this side, it must make sure that it's just it's closed properly so that it doesn't sort of it doesn't exactly line up on this machine. I'm not sure if it ever was supposed to, but basically there. So your threads, threading your machine when you've you've sat at the right height, you're threading your machine. The first thing to do is to make sure you've pulled the telescopic thread guide up. Now I'm not 100% sure whether you have to go through the hole in the top of this one as well, but I've just slotted them through there. If you can see my finger, slotted them through there, through the guides. So this needs to be through the top. Before you start sewing on anything, always make sure it's not caught underneath your thread. See there? Caught underneath it. So you just want to make sure that it's not all of these here. If you want to have a quick look over here, see some of these are a little bit dangling down the edge here. They can't be caught. Alright, so I'm going to change the threads on these, but I need to show you the cheats way first. I would get a really good photo of your tensions too and make sure that they don't alter once your machine's set up perfectly. Why alter it unless you're going to change something about it, whether it's the fabric or the thread that you're actually using. So this is the cheats way of changing a thread. Now I haven't actually threaded these up with the right colours. A good suggestion to re-thread your machine and to get to know your machine is to thread your machine in the exact colours that they've got on the machine here, on the guides. All the way through here you'll see that all the dots in here, green, so to thread this up here through here, green, 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 through there, and it goes under here, there's another one, and back up through there. So anyway, let's go through the cheats way to start off with. So green, we're going to do the green one first. So tie a knot in it. You'll be gentle with it, because if you're being rough, you could pull it out from the other end. So just take your time. I will show you how to actually do it as well, but this is the cheats way. Now I'm chopping that about a centimetre, and I pull them out first. Alrighty, and see how it's all dangling down here now? Now I've got to be very careful for the next one. So yellow, I'm going to put the yellow on the next one. This is the upper looper. I've just started from the right hand side and I'm working my way through to the left. So again, chopping it back to about a centimetre from my knot. And then I check my knot. Just make sure it's not going to slide out, because if it's going to slide out, then you're going to find yourself re-threading the machine. And that can take ages. Right, what colour's next? Blue. It's kind of a good idea to get threads that haven't got anything that's going to catch on the top. Just be with me. Like, these have a little slot in there when they were made. These are the old-fashioned silkos. But when they come up off the top, they would catch. So if that sat on there, it would catch on it, which is a great idea for domestic, for the, you know, but at the same time it's not ideal for overlocking. Threads don't have to be great quality for overlocking, they just have to be of similar, or ideally similar strength, if you can get that. So again, checking to see that it's going to be strong enough. And the red one, which is the outer needle thread. There's a guide here. Basically, the needle breaks, it's not going to hit you in the eyes. So you can start by pulling these through one at a time. Now, the ideal way is to cut the thread and gently pull it through. Just gentle. If you feel like it's a bit tight, sometimes you can pull the tension discs out if you want to, or just help it through each stage, just gently. See, sometimes I'm just pulling that a little bit more. Now, these tweezers are invaluable basically for an overlocker. I always cut the thread first, get a nice sharp edge. I've got these amazing scissors here for that. Just got to get rid of the other one the other way. Now this is where my eyesight's not the best now. There we go. See, it's caught under here, so make sure it's not caught on anything. Take your time. And there we go, from front to back. Same with the next one. Right, I've already... white one. I think some people say do it from right to left. I'm not really that worried. See, it's caught up again, so you just got to watch what it's getting caught on. And I'm pulling it through slowly. Make sure there's a bit, you know, like a good bit of thread on the other side. If you have it too too little on the other arm, that you're trying to save thread on the outside, it can bounce back into the machine, so it's more of a hassle in this way. These threads aren't great quality, so I'm just kind of like making sure that they get a bit hairy. Okay, I've got both these threads, the red and the blue, which is the two needle threads, through the needles, which is coming from the front of the machine towards the back of the machine. I lift up the presser foot with the little lever at the back here. This one, you lift it up and down one. And now what I want to do is to try and get these through the bag. And out of the way. So they're going to hook under there. There's a little, in the foot here, there's a little cavity where it should slot underneath. And that gets them out of the way. Now, these other ones, let's get the, take the green one through. We'll do the outer one, the under one first. So I'm just pulling this through. I need to open that up. So I'm just pulling it through a little bit at a time. Making sure it doesn't get caught. So it's feeling tight there now. Where's it getting caught? Oh, it's getting caught just there. Jiggle it. And there it goes. Ideal. So it's getting caught in the same spot again. Oh, that caught. That's interesting. That broke. So now I need to re-thread it. Yay. Oh no, I just got it. Phew. And there we go. It's come right through now. So just cut all these off. Remove any other threads. Right, so what I'm doing here is I'm going to grab my tweezers again and I'm going to get the looper threads through to the back as well. And also get them underneath the presser foot. So I've got one, two, and there should be green on there. Right, I've got all four. Close them up, make sure they're closed properly. Put that guard back in place. And basically, when you're sewing, overlocking, you use your right foot, unless you, I mean, if you kick a ball with the right foot, well, then it would be your right foot you're using. Now, you need to, it's about holding your hands in the correct position when you're overlocking. So, it's different, overlocking is a little bit different to the domestic machine, and normal machine. So I'm holding my hand here and here. This hand here is holding it there and it doesn't go, it's going nowhere near the blade. My job here is to make sure where the blade is, which is right in line with that. I believe on this machine it's this little ridge here. You work out which machine you've got and how it cuts off. But you don't want to cut much off. So of the key is not to cut much off at all. And this hand here, it's just to guide it through as it goes. And its other job here for this hand is to make sure you haven't got any other fabric pulled underneath when you're coming through. The main reason for threading them in the same colours as the machine is to just get to know where, if something breaks or something like that, is to know how to thread your machine. And see, that's how it's looking there. So this is your needle thread, your needle thread, the top looper, and the green underneath. This has been serviced. I'm not going to fiddle with the tensions at the moment, but because the whole idea that the person's asked me to just show them the threading and how to run their fabric through the machine. So it's not ideal when you're sewing to just go, oh, I'm going to chop a whole pile off like this. It's probably better to cut it on the table and work it out that way. And then just sew the edges. And this one here, see, if you can't get your fingers close, just don't. This hand here is going to guide it through. That's probably why I keep really long fingernails, is so that I'll never sew my fingers. And then cut the picking out the pins. Right. So. Clearing out your junk. Right. So I want to rethread it from scratch. Alright, so I hardly ever lift up the presser foot. You just leave it down. You run, when you're sewing, you really should have a bit of thread before you start. Like out to here's a good starting point. Otherwise it can get jammed inside the machine. And when you're finished, it's different to a normal machine because you don't cut threads off and pull them out. You never pull them out, you sew them out. So you sew to the end. And that, like I said, keep it out here somewhere. I'll do it again so you can see what I mean. See, if I'm trying to get something through the machine like this, I'd hold it out here. I wouldn't put my fingers up here close to do it. And again, my fingers are always curved here. And if this hand, it's okay for it to just not have a big function. This hand here will do it. And as long as I'm keeping that curved, I'm not going to have a problem. And run it out to the side. Okay? This machine has a couple of guides here, so if you wanted to cut off 1 centimetre, you can do it like this. I just prefer to always overlock on the edge and cut it first. But yeah, see the guide there telling me 1 centimetre I'm going to cut off. The other thing that I wanted to tell you was this here is for putting the presser on the pressure foot. So you'd hardly ever alter it unless you're actually doing something really delicate and it was like leaving marks underneath from the feed dogs, or you're doing something really heavy duty and you want to give it a bit more room. The other thing is when you're using that hand wheel over here, the hand wheel has an arrow on it, and you pull it, this machine requires it to be pulled over towards yourself, over the top and over towards yourself. Alright, we're going to thread the machine from scratch next. Okay, I'm starting from scratch. I'm going to take this thread out. I'm just going to take one out at a time. Very good idea is to take a photo of all these points here for yourself. Even take a photo of all the tensions while you're at it. If you've got your machine all set up and this is your first time, this thread for the green, it goes. So we'll show you all the guides. Up to the top, through this one, through this guide, through this. This goes clockwise round. That must hook up through this little lever there, up and over, through this guide, through this guide, through this guide here. Now, this is where it gets tricky. There's actually one over the other side here, a little guide, and it comes up here through the through the looper and from the front to the back. Now I'm going to just cut this and pull this out and see how good I am at doing this. Just the green. Because you're going to break the thread at some stage, we all do. And you need to know how to thread it again because you start sewing and it's all disappeared. Right, up through the top, through the first guide, remembering that I've already pulled this right to its maximum up here. Now, this slides in through there, okay? Through this one from the left to the right, clockwise around this, and it goes up, so you pull it right up and down through there. Through this one, straight across to this other green one here. And there's another little green one here. And I'm pulling it through to the other side here to do this. And there's another little hook here. Making sure that nothing else is looped through here or over the top of this looper, because it's just going to be a nuisance. Which that one still had a bit of thread on it from before. Now, challenge is to get it back. That's where these tweezers come in. Oh, it's come out the other side again. That might be the quickest way. Just leave it, pull it back through, and pull it back out that way. And now front to back. This one, that's a nuisance, it's from before. Now, watching that it hasn't got caught on anything random, like it has, see down there, wrong place, caught again down there. And there we are. Right, and then this needs to go through the back again. And I'm pulling it through so that it sits under. Right, that's good to go. Now at this stage you can test it to see if your machine's running again. Each one, I don't think I will for the sake of this video. You've seen me run the machine before. Right, let's do the yellow one. I'll just cut the threads too. In fact, I'll get rid of the needle threads while we're at it. Get it out of the way. Yellow thread. This should be the upper looper. So I'll just show you again where it's going. So through this, as it comes out, through this guide here, around through here, through this guide here, through this one here. They've all got little yellow dots. This machine's, you know, for its age, is in very good condition. Alrighty, keep those out of the way. Okay, so we're going to put the yellow one back through. Through there. Through this one here. Hold them and they slot them beautifully through there, through the tension, those of you who don't know what the tensions are, the tensions help them, I'm just working out whether that one goes behind it, because this is not my machine. We'll find out. I think it does, actually. Let's set back a little bit. The slides under here. Exposes that one. The under looper. Or is this the top looper? I'm getting confused now. Why not? The top looper. There we go. Alright, let's go to the needle threads. Oh, see, already I've got a problem, which I didn't even notice about up here. Try not to have anything like that happen. So, the blue thread should be going up through there. This is your right needle. There, around through here, clockwise again, through the side here. You can see these little guides here. Now these two, the two needle threads, both go through the same guide here. This one and this little take-up lever goes through there and back through those two again. This is where they separate again. There's a left one and a right one. And now through the needle. Alright, so I'll cut this thread and re-thread it from scratch. You've got to make sure you get them through the tension guides. There's two discs in there that are quite close together, and that the tensions are just so that it will show you how much allows how much thread that goes through for each stitch. So this goes through this one here. I might actually take the red one out at the same time. It might be easier to do them both at the same time. I'll just show you this red one at the same time. There. That guide around the tension. Through that hole that I'm trying to thread through there. Take up lever is just a hook, so it doesn't need to go through. It just needs to sit in front of it. Through this hole, through there. That guide, and then through the needle. Oh, actually there's one more guide there, but I'll show it to you in a second. So, red one. Left needle, just make sure this is straighter. Yep, left needle. Caught behind that little disc through there. This is why I wanted to do it to view that, because I figured that I could get them through at the same time. As long as they don't twist up together, that's the only thing, I suppose. No? I want to go separately? Okay, fine. Let's do one then. Through here. Oh, that one slots down actually. This is even better. It just slots down. You don't have to try and thread it. I wonder if that one goes up through the bottom. I'll have a look at that. Blue, through that one. Through the right one. Through the little guide there. and through the right needle with it. And now the red one. I'm just thinking, does it go up through there and end up in that slot? Oh, it does. It's even better than I thought. And then that one just goes down there. Oh, wow. I'm used to industrial machines and they aren't this nice to thread. Things being correct, you should have four threads out the side here. Make sure they're all going out through the middle of this little gap that's in the foot. Close the guard. I've worked out why this machine's got a little crack in here. That's why this plate here is not sitting 100%, but never mind. I think it's in the 80s, this machine. Close the guard, put your foot down, and grab a strip of fabric and have a go. I'll keep my fingers crossed. Machine is threaded from scratch. For me, because I've been in the industry for quite a while, little things that I'm just going to point out when you're overlocking. As I said, guide that through. Now this is where you can, say you're doing a big skirt and there's lots and lots of fabric and you're pushing it all through. This hand here is to make sure all the fabric goes through. You've got to always watch that you don't accidentally sew over here, because the minute this sews together, you've cut it. So you better just stop, lift the pressure foot up, get rid of the extra fabric. And you can feel it, this hand here is to feel the extra layers of fabric for it. Hi, look, to oil the machine, there's little dots here, little red dots. I saw some more before there. If you get your oiling can and just put a couple of dobs of oil on it, use sewing machine oil, not food oil, but sewing machine oil. And yeah, there's a couple here. I thought I saw more before, but again, it's not my machine. So, but if you can put some spots on it from time to time, it should keep running really well. The other thing is get yourself a clean paintbrush, like a brand new one that's not been used for any paint, and come in here and, or a pastry brush, and flick it through and get all the lint out. That keeps the machine going well too. The other thing that I didn't think I discussed in my previous information was when sewing seams, or the machine is a four thread machine, this one, the four thread machine, it's a mock safety stitch machine, is what we've got here. Now I'm just going to try it on different fabrics, because again, this I've never done it. So this is sweatshirting. This is two layers of fabric. I just want to see how much the machine sews well through there. Now remembering I've got different coloured threads. So it's got a bit of what we call in the trade grinning going on. So that you can see the teeth, so they're grinning. So I'm not sure if it needs altering. But personally, if you're only doing one-offs, you may as well just run a row of normal stitching beside it. So I just wanted to see how it would sew through different seams. So I'll go again over this. Running it on. Keeping my fingers out of the way. If you're coming to a seam, it's kind of always quite good to push one seam one way, one the other way, to get, unless the machine thinks otherwise, but to get the bulk away from it. It's not too bad, it's sewn over it alright. I've got some upholstery fabric here. Let's have a go at seeing how that goes through it. Sewing fine so far. I would imagine, and I do not know, but I would imagine the needles are probably the stock standard needles for this machine, like the 130. You'd have to do your own research for that, because I haven't had to change a needle on it. But look, this is four layers of upholstery fabric that's gone through it quite nicely. A mock safety stitch is really for stretch, so what have I got here? Stretchy, oh, here we go. This is super stretchy fabric, so. I actually want to start at the end, actually, when I think about it. Probably should be sewing on bigger pieces of fabric, but it's just what I had to hand. Alright, so sewing on the super stretcher, let's see, have a look. See, it doesn't pop any of the stitches, so it's worked quite nicely on here. So for t-shirting, I see it's not as grinning, it's not grinning as much there, but then it wouldn't be showing the grinning quite so much if it was the right coloured thread. So a bit of denim here. Which I've used for testing other machines as well. Okay, so I must have about three layers there when I get to the other side of denim. So going over seams, go slower, you don't have to go fast. good super.